Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.1, Problem 2. This is Section 2.1, Problem 2. It says a recent survey of BCC students showed the following results on what source of news that students rely on. So, for television, 181 students got news from television. The internet, 248 students got news from the internet. Newspaper, only 25 students got their news from the newspaper. And on the radio, 106 students got their news from the radio. So there are four parts to this. Part A says, create a relative frequency table from the frequency table shown above. So to turn this into a relative frequency table, basically we're going to add a column onto it. And that column is going to have some ratios of these frequencies over the total of all the frequencies. So let's see if I can set up a similar table right next to this with one additional column. So the first one will stay the same. News source. And the same news sources. One is television. These are very common news sources. Internet. Newspaper. And radio. So the first column stays exactly the same, unchanged. The next column for a relative frequency table is the same, still frequency. So the frequency for TV is 181, the frequency for internet is 248, the frequency for newspaper is 25, the frequency for radio is 106. So now here's where it becomes different. So for a relative frequency table, the last column is relative frequency. I'm going to need to know the total of all the frequencies, which I can add up quick enough. You could certainly use a calculator. These numbers aren't too bad. 1 and 8 is 9, 9 and 5 is 14, 14 and 6 more would be 20. Put the 0 carry the 2. 2 plus 8 is 10, 10 plus 4 is 14, 14 plus 2 is 16, 16 plus 0 is still 16. Put down the 0 carry the 1. 1 and 1 is 2. 2 and 2 is 4, 4 plus 1 more is 5. So if I've done my math correctly, there are a total of 560 in the frequency column. So now to make relative frequencies, for television, the relative frequency would be the frequency for television of 181 over the total of all the frequencies, which is 560. The relative frequency for the internet, forgot to cross my T, is the frequency for the internet, 248. Over the total of all the frequencies, 560. The relative frequency for newspaper is the frequency for newspaper of 25 over the total of all the frequencies, 560. And finally, the relative frequency for the radio is the frequency for the radio of 106 over the total of all the frequencies, 560. Your ratios of, say, 181 over 560 can be turned into decimals easily enough. You don't have to. Some people really prefer to see the decimals. So as an additional step with your calculator, you could just divide out 181 divide by 560 equals, you get a decimal, you could round it off. And you could do that for all of them. But the fractions are okay too. It's an equivalent value. You could write either one. So that's part A. This is your relative frequency table as opposed to just a frequency table. So B, draw a bar graph for the frequency table shown above. So I want a bar graph that's going to have these four bars, and the frequencies will determine the heights of the bars. Now here's the thing, my biggest bar is going to go up to 248, so I should have some sort of a number scale for that. I'd rather not make 248 little lines for my bar graph for the scale. I could, but that would be awful. So you go 100 at a time. That would probably not really be enough. You'd only need two or three lines, and numbers like, you know, 106 and 181 wouldn't look too different. 50 at a time is not a bad choice. Five lines will get you up to 250, or 25 at a time, 25 at a time, 10 lines would go up to 250. So I'm going to choose 25 at a time. You can really choose whatever scale you want as long as you label it clearly. And what you want to do is see what your biggest bar will be and base your number scale on that. So the fact that my biggest bar is almost 250, the scale of 25 at a time seems pretty sensible. 50 at a time would be fine too. If you want to, you could go say 36.8 at a time, as long as you label it, but why pick something so tedious? So I'm going to come off to the side and start setting up my number scale at least, and keep in mind I'm going to have four bars. So let me start my bar graph. I'm going to want my number scale. And I figured 10 lines at 25 at a line would work out well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And as I label that, it would be 25, 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 175, 200, 225, 250. That should accommodate my highest bar and all the others. So the first bar I have will be for television. It has a frequency of 181, so its bar will have a height of 181. As I come to my number scale, I don't have a height of precisely 181. So by eye, you figure it has to be between the 175 and the 200. So 181 would be, you know, maybe like a quarter of the way up. So I'm gonna go here. I have decided to draw my bars vertically, but a bar graph could go horizontal or vertical. It's your choice. I decided to do vertical. We have to label the bars. So I'll write right on the bar, television. You could also write it underneath. So the next bar will be for the internet. It has a frequency of 248. So the bar will have a height of 248. Now again, I don't have precisely a number of 248 on my number scale, but I know it's going to be a very tiny bit shorter than the 250. So very tiny bit shorter than the 250. Again, the bar will be vertical. It's not supposed to touch the other bar. There should be a space. And the bar should be labeled. And now the next bar will be for newspaper. It goes to a height of 25. Its frequency is 25. Its bar will have a height of 25. And I do have exactly 25 on my number scale, so I'll make it exactly 25. I'll label my bar. And finally, the last one for radio has a frequency of 106. The bar will have a height of 106. I don't have a number of precisely 106, so I can see it should be a little more than a 100. Notice there's a space between the bars. And that's the bar graph, and we can certainly label it. It's nice for your bar graph to have a title, Sources of News. And that's the answer to B. B says draw a bar graph for the frequency table that was given in the problem. And now C says draw a Pareto for the frequency table that was given. So for Pareto, what we have to do is arrange the bars in order. Now, the way they're written here, the tallest bar is not first, so I would have to rearrange all of them pretty much. I would have to put the internet first, then television, then radio, then newspaper last. So let me make one right next to it. It's going to have the same number scale. I'm just going to rearrange the bars. Same number scale, so I've made 10 little lines. And I'll do 25, 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 175, 200, 225, and 250. So it's going to look really similar, but if My graph now is a Pareto. I have to put the tallest bar first for internet, which had a height of 248. So internet's going to come first. I'll label the bar. Television is the next tallest bar at a height of 181, so it will come next. Again, I don't have exactly 181. I will estimate as best I can. Radio will come next. It had a height of 106. So again, I don't have exactly 106 on my number scale, but I'll come pretty close. Again, I'll label it. And finally, newspaper was last. It had a height of 25. I do have exactly 25 on my number scale, so I'll label that bar also. The bars need to be labeled. And you have to have a clear number scale. So now it's a Pareto because the bars are arranged in order of height. And finally, the last part of the question asked, what problem might you have if you attempted to draw a pie chart for this information? So again, pie chart, the circular graph with the different wedges. Not everything is well suited to be turned into a pie chart, and this is one of those problems. And the reason is a lot of people can get their news from more than one source, and it's not clear which wedge of the pie chart to put them in. For a bar graph, it's okay. It just makes each bar bigger. But for the pie chart, that can be a problem. A lot of people use internet and television, so that's why you might have a problem if you try to do a pie chart with this data.